when you're fixing a feather edge cladding, this is an existing bit of feather edge cladding I've got here on this site, and I've noticed that it's been fixed with more of a second fixed brad, and they've also fixed it, if you look at this brad, they've also fixed it with one which isn't that suitable for outdoors. If you're going to do this, you really want a stainless steel one, because even the galvanized ones that you find, it only says suitable for indoor use. And the problem with using a brad is you can clearly see it here, it's just pulled away, it's just not got enough strength. And the other problem is, as the boards get the sunshine on and this side dries out, it's like a bimetallic strip and it wants to curve out. So all the moisture comes out of this side and it curves out, it shrinks. And then that's what gives you this gap here. If you watch me, I can tap it back there. And that's not really good for insects and all the rest of it. You really don't want that. So if you're gonna fix this cladding, you really want to use a nail with a head. You either want to use, if it's oak, you've got to use a stainless steel nail. You can get them for your nail guns. If it's a traditional treated softwood like this, a galvanized nail or galvanized plus nail is absolutely fine. And as I've said before, you really don't want to catch the board underneath. So in this instance, you can see they've actually caught the board underneath. They've got three fixings there. So instead of three fixings, you just need one decent fixing, a nail with a head. And the other beautiful thing about that is in the future, if you just get a bit of movement, you can just tap them back. Whereas these, no matter what you do, it's gonna always pull away because there is no head. It's just a very, very small, in this case, rusty pin. So I'll let that be a bit of a sort of warning to you if you are thinking of using a brad or a pin. So here's a section through. I've just put these here to give you an example. There's the cover there. That allows for shrinkage. There's the nail there, and it comes in just above the top of the other board, all right? So that's the correct way of fixing it. The other way in tradition as well is if you were hand nailing this, you aim the nail back there. When this board shrinks that way, which they do, because the nail is aimed that way, it pulls itself tight to the one underneath, okay? So that's a traditional technique, that's the way we were taught years ago.